As shown by history, one of the beauty of genuinely creating any form of art or visioning a big dream is the fact that no matter the challenges you face in your lifetime, you are constantly dedicated to it till the very end.
Other factors being considered anyways. So to the people of the future, I say hello in any way you all are going to be greeting each other by that time. And to the people of the present, welcome to another extremely enlightening episode of HMIH podcast with your personal person. Yes, Damila Imapa. On today's episode, fam, I'm going to be briefly telling you about the quite interesting lifetime of a classical musician. You all have probably heard his compositions before and has had amazing impact up until this very day. Yes, which is about 251 years since his birth. Wow, that's incredible. Born on the 17th December 1770 in a city in Germany called Bonn, funny right? Our most influential human for today, Ludwig van Beethoven, was given birth into a family of musicians. His father and grandfather were choir singers at their times, and they prospered quite well. Up until the death of Beethoven's grandfather in 1773, sadly, his father also severed his career because of subsequent addiction to alcohol, probably because of depression. Just a wild guess though. Beethoven showed great musical talent from a very young age, especially on the piano. And as much as his dad wanted him to become a young musical success, being his first musical teacher, he became extremely and intensively strict in teaching his young son, most probably because of monetary gain. Oh well, this may have helped Beethoven as he had his very first stage performance at the young age of 8. But unfortunately, his father's wish for him to become a young prodigy because of envy of someone else's children didn't quite come to pass. Although the second born of about 7 children, Beethoven was the eldest surviving son of his parents, Johann and Maria Magdalene van Beethoven, as he lost most of his siblings due to illnesses at a very young age. And at age 16, when he briefly went to Vienna to advance in his musical career, his mother died of tuberculosis, so he had to come back home to Bonn, and eventually became the only possible breadwinner of his family, taking care of his two remaining younger brothers as his father became more and more addicted to alcohol up until the very end. Despite all these predicaments and so many more, Beethoven continued to advance and prosper in his musical career, composing amazing and beautiful classical music. His works is said to feature the transition from the classical period to the romantic era in classical music. And listening to his beautiful compositions, which most times moved his audiences to tears because of the emotional rush he gave them, you'd understand how beautiful and amazing his works are. Beethoven's career, which was firstly divided by one of his biographers, Wilhelm von Enz, has widely and most agreeably been split into 3 periods. The first period, during which he forged his craft, is said to be between the beginning of his musical career up until 1802, followed by the second period, which showed an impressive improvement of the classical styles of 2 of his mentors, Mozart and Haydn. And it was also during this period he started to suffer from hearing problems, till he eventually became deaf, which was the gravest predicament of his lifetime, after which he thought of suicide. But his love for his art and strong belief of overcoming the biggest challenge of any musician, not being able to hear their own music, he confidently continued composing and was able to still create amazing works after he was almost totally deaf. And then the third and final period, which surprisingly showed an extended innovation and creativity in his musical form and expression. It was during this period he performed one of his best compositions called the Ninth Symphony to the biggest audience after his deafness, which at the end gathered an extremely large standing ovation. Just wonderful. Well, as all will, Ludwig van Beethoven died. He died from liver damage on 26th March 1827, aged 56. His funeral, which was on 29th March 1827, was attended by more than 10,000 people. Some even say it's about 20,000 people. But whichever it may be, What matters was the fact that this 56-year-old influential human, despite all odds and obstacles, was able to gather the love and definitely envious hatred through the dedication and love for his art. And that is the end of today's story or narration or history, whichever it is for you. All I hope is that you gain something from it. And on that note, I bid you farewell. Damilare Mapa out.